Hi, this is Dennis with Second Chance Tackle. I thought I'd share with you a little rig that I make. It's kind of shortcutting the fly tying process, but it's been a rig that has been very effective in dealing with striper blues, which are in the bays this time of year. And many of us are aware that there's been a plug or a rig that's on the market now for quite some time, probably at least the last decade, a little styrofoam popper and a little rubber worm or something to the like, trailing about 20 inches behind the popper. They've been pretty deadly, but I think the fish are onto it. I think they understand what that little rubber piece is now. And I just came across a rig that I've been using this season very effectively, and it's a shortcut on a saltwater fly, so I thought I would share that with you today. And I'm going to go primitive on this one. I'm not going to use my fly tying or my jig tying vices or anything, because I want everybody to understand this is a do-it-at-home project, and it really is a shortcut. So what you want to do is you want to get a snelled hook, no bother to tie it up yourself, and look for one with a longer shank on it. So this is a flounder hook, but you want that longer shank because these fish are aggressive and tend to swallow hooks. And with that, we're just simply going to take the back end of that hook and put it into our bench vise. Keep the barb out of the vise. You don't want to break that at all. And then I'm going for a pre-tied flash teaser. I prefer the green or the chartreuse. And we're going to use that for our trailing flash. So I start with some thread. Again, I have the thread that's fly tying thread, but you know, go in your closet and just grab any old light thread, if you will, and we'll show you how to tie this one up and make a very effective lure, kind of as a homemade project. So I start with some fly head cement. I'm just going to put a little dab up top where I'm going to tie my my start for my thread. Grab the thread and let's just get that started here. It's just several wraps. There's no knots on the front end. You just wrap. And with this one, you just got to be careful because you're going to be twisting that the lead snell on it a couple of times. But once you do a few wraps, you should be tight on that. And then you can simply lay the thread down. Those of you that had a fly tying bobbin, which I do, you know, go ahead and use that. But again, I'm trying to make this as simple as I can and as straightforward. So I'm going to take the teaser, and I'm just going to grab a hunk of the metallics, and that's going to form our fly. Now this fly emulates bait fish that are up here in the northeast in the waters that are being chased by these baby bluefish or the snappers. Once I do that, I simply continue wrapping, covering all of it, making sure that that's secure. And I'm actually wrapping behind the snell, and then I'll go over the snell a little bit, and then I'll just do a quick finishing knot. And the finishing knot is simply just grabbing the line, wrapping it, and then passing the snell through that as such. Sometimes my hands are too big for things. We'll get it. Okay, and then once you get the knot, just roll it over the top and pull down. And I like to do two knots on that, so I'll show it to you again. You just grab your four fingers, you roll to create the internal knot, make that hole big enough that you can slide the snell through, bring it back over the top, line it up with where you've done your tying, and then clip it off. And then I just finish again with a little bit of fly cement. I'm using a cotton swab for my applicator, and I'll just put a little bit of cement on there to hold the knots in place. And there you have it. You have a homemade rig for a snapper. This will emulate a spearing as your that looks like I got a little over there. It's going to emulate a little spearing or a bait fish. It's got plenty of flash. And again, if you're out there looking, used to seeing something like this, it's a little bit different, but it's an easy thing to do. You probably get, if you buy this flash teasers, there's two to a pack. You can probably snell up about six or seven of these. Buy a pack of the hooks that are pre-snelled with, this has nine in a pack. So for about $3.50, you've got seven or eight of these. They will get chewed up over time because the bluefish are aggressive, but a lot of fun, something different that they haven't seen, and something that I have had a lot of luck with this season. So I just want to pass that tip along to you. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you do, please subscribe to my channel. You'll see more of these things from time to time, but predominantly, as you know, it's reel repair. But every now and then we do get to go fishing, and this is a great little lure to catch something that's very seasonal at the moment. So with that, I'm going to thank you for viewing. This is Dennis with Second Chance Tackle. Good luck fishing.